Yo.
Shade Bean and Billin, how you feeling? And in this video, I'm going to be telling y'all the way on how to still remain happy while not having any money. Here's how you do it. I'm going to tell you how to do it, so make sure you stay until the end of the video. Here we go. How to remain happy while not having no money. Now, we look on social media, and of course, we go on Instagram, TikTok, Twitter, and we'll see how many women are projecting their faults onto other men. So they want to project onto men to have six figures, be the breadwinner, be the provider, right? Financially, I'm saying. That's their criteria, but they don't have these same criteria themselves. They don't fall in them lines either, because one thing y'all need to realize is a quote unquote broke woman is not going to be with another broke man. A broke woman is going to always look up. They're smart when it comes to the rule that I'm about to tell you on how to remain happy while not having no money. They are the masters at that because they know how to look up. They know how to intentionally just shoot their arrow up in the sky and see where they land while not having no money, having a low-tier job that they hate. So fellas, here's how you do it. You ready? The art of visualization and the art of intent. In other words, you could say the art of visualization and the power of intent. Very important you watch what you say and you watch what you consume. It's very important that you know, even though you have no money, that doesn't make you. It's almost like having a bad experience happen to you. And you become that experience. So you kind of become skeptic, paranoid. You one foot in, one foot out. You playing a 50, right? So let's say you get in a wreck. And you were in a wreck by yourself, gladly. You came out fine, no injuries, right? But every time you step foot in a car now, you're going to be paranoid, going extra slow, extra cautious. And a wise man once told me while playing sports, if you play like you hurt, you're going to get hurt. So it's the same thing when it comes to life, because life is a game too. So with the power of visualization, here's what you do. Every single day, you don't look at your bank account. You don't look at that number because that number doesn't dictate who and what you stand for. Don't look at your bank account, and every single day on the way to work, on the way to get some money, in the car, Ubering, walking, put your phone down. Do not disturb, airplane mode. And you visualize you walking into your own corporation, you walking into your own business with your own merch, with your own studio, music, art, paintings, barbershop, studio, whatever you got going on, you visualize that. Play that over and over in your head. The same way you replay a song that you love is the same way you should be replaying your dreams. Replaying those top goals and priorities you have in your life. Don't let the boss at work make you. Because when they tell you at work, yo, get up, file them cabinets, put the drawers in there, you know, go outside, come back in 10 minutes. Specific, right? Almost like you a puppet. So you telling me you're not going to put that same energy into yourself? When you tell yourself, I'm going to sit down after work, after I shower, after I eat, one concise hour of learning how to code, how to design clothes, how to make videos better, how to focus on lighting, the cameras, new cameras, new microphones, new headsets, new equipment, whatever it is, that's what you focus on for an hour. So what you say is what you become. That's why I told y'all, watch what you consume. Because if you listen to other people tell you, I'm a 18-year-old billionaire, and here's how I did it, you're automatically gonna consume your life where you're at right now at 21, 18, 19, 20. And you're gonna be like, damn, I'm not where he's at. So let me tune in like he got the right answers. Newsflash, anybody on the internet can say, I'm a 19-year-old with $1 million in my bank account. Here's how I did it. It's Cal. That's their marketing strategy. Most of these people's marketing strategy is fake it all the way until they quote unquote make it. Then they're gonna flex like they made it. But they faked it first. Don't hate the player, hate the game. You gotta find your lane. You gotta mind your business. So we already talked about the art of visualization. And this is what you do every day. You write it down. You look at it. Have it in your wallet. Have it in your pocket. Have it as your screensaver. Y'all see my screensaver right now? Look at my screensaver. Look at my screensaver right now. Everything you desire is working in your favor. Keep living divine with your true self. I don't play around. I do not play around. So I see this every day. It's like a mantra. I say it to myself every day. Your goals should be the first thing on your mind and the last thing with you when you go to sleep. It should be what you think about every day. Every day, every night, when you wake up, brushing your teeth, in the car, going to the gym, at the gym, working out, shooting. And yes, it can get tiring at times. It can. Being so focused on money and, you know, climbing the ladder, it can be tiring at times. But that's why you stop, then go. Stop, then go. Stop, then go. How far do you want to go with your journey? You got to get gas. You got to stop and get gas. There's no such thing as eternal gas. Whether you got a Tesla, a G-Wagon, a Benz, Ferrari, Lamborghini, a Honda Civic, Honda CRV, it don't matter what car. You got to get gas. You got to go to the pump. Or you got to go to the charging station for the Teslas, you know, for the energy power shit, the solar power shit. You got to go to the air and you got to re-up. And it's going to take you some time. But you get back on the road and you keep pushing. Now, let's go to the power of intent. Because they go hand in hand. Is what you do in your day-to-day pushing you forward to your goals? Ask yourself that question right now, sitting at home, on your couch, on your bed, laying down. Ask yourself that question. If the answer is no, here's what you could do. With being intentional, you must know every time I step foot outside this house, it is moving me closer to my purpose. How I talk to people, how I talk to myself, how I view people, how I view myself, what I think about money, how I view the rich, how I view the poor, how I view the middle class, how I view myself, how I view dogs, workers, employees, bosses. Everything makes you get a step further or behind in your process. Yes, it does. Yes, it does. So with being intentional, think about it in the form of a woman. If I know my true intentions with a woman, I'm gonna let her know that. I'm gonna let her know that because honesty is the best policy. Of course, you gotta, you know, bend the truth a little bit here and there, but being honest, you will get so much further being honest and straight up with a little bit of politeness. You will go so much further. You won't have to be sneaky. You won't have to get away with shit. You won't have to. Why? Because you already were intentional about what you wanted. So either you're with that or you're not. Straight up. So when it comes to your goals, when it comes to building a better foundation for your financial journey, this is what I want. I'm going to take this amount of time, 2 years, 36 months, 12 months, 8 months, and put my head down, not going out, not getting a haircut. I'm not spending my money, getting my nails done, feet done. I'm cooking. I'm staying in the house. I'm locking in, and I'm staying focused. I'm staying focused. Where my energy goes is where my attention flows. I need that to flow because that will be my income. Herein comes the flow of energy. And what is energy? Money, currency, power, all of its power. You see where I'm going with this? So this is how to remain happy. while not having a lot of money. Because if you constantly look at other people's lives, you won't be able to be happy. You won't. Because you're constantly in comparison. It's like you can't wait so bad to live their life for them. Not live your life for you. So you could be 25, 20, just graduating high school, 18, 17, going to college maybe, not having... And you looking at everybody else on how to get money, but you're not putting the steps forward into executing on your plan. You're not doing that. You are not doing that. And it's actually, all of this is a mind hack. This is all a mind hack. So take these tips, take these keys, take these gems, and execute on your purpose. We all want to be financially stable, right? Financially free. Do what we want, when we want, how we want, go as we please, when we please. That's gonna take some time. So you need to put your head down and focus. It's not gonna come overnight. He who thinks he's wrong and he who thinks he's right, they're both right. They are both right in their own way. Stay focused, fellas.